Roswell, New Mexico, the place where many believe the government's cover-up of UFOs began. July 1947, ranchers Dee Proctor and Mac Brazel discover what they believe to be the remains of a crashed alien spaceship. However, the military seizes the wreckage and declares the downed craft is just a simple weather balloon. There are allegations of a cover-up, but no hard evidence. But what if the military didn't capture all of the wreckage? Could the New Mexico desert still be hiding the ultimate proof that UFOs exist and have visited our world?
Everybody's heard of the UFO crash at Roswell, New Mexico in 1947. But Roswell is where the story ends. Corona is where the story begins. That's where the debris site was found. My newest informant is a federal employee with high security clearance. He's leaking certain information to me, and it doesn't get bigger than this. A map allegedly drawn by the rancher who buried the Roswell UFO debris. This ex-government official says this map leads to a cave where this corona debris is hidden. And if we can find that debris, it will prove there is life on other planets.
Chuck is meeting with Heather at a local diner in Corona to update her on the investigation.
Heather.
Hey, Chuck.
How are we doing?
Good. I'm so excited to be here.
You know about the Roswell crash of 1947?
But of course.
Everybody knows about the debris site where the craft came down.
Uh-huh.
Been all over the news. But a lesser known story is about a Corona local actually found some of the material and hid it in a cave.
Wow.
And people have been looking for that cave for decades.
When the craft collided with the ground, there was a severe thunderstorm. And it's believed that the wreckage was scattered over 30 miles and across three counties.
Well, this is a map my informant says will lead us to the cave.
The Roswell Corona crash, and it's the most well-known case in ufology. Finding the debris would be a game changer.
So this is the crash site, and then 17 miles.
Here's the cave.
So we think some of the debris is in this cave.
Yeah, this is a pretty crude map. We need someone to help us figure this out. So I reached out to a guy named Sandy Proctor. He's one of Dee Proctor's only surviving relatives.
He's definitely probably been to the debris site before.
Yeah.
Dee Proctor was just 7 years old in 1947 when he and Mac Brazel discovered strange debris on Dee's family ranch.
We can actually talk to someone that's part of the Proctor family, and we'll show him the map to see if he can point us to the right direction.
This is getting exciting.
Are you ready to go?
Yes.
Let's rock.
Chuck and Heather head to the Proctor ranch. Alleged to have been strewn with UFO debris during the Roswell crash.
The military came in, and if they heard any rumors at all of someone having debris, they would track that person down and take it from them. Now you tell me why they would do that if it was a weather balloon. For the longest time, there were accusations that the Proctors had material and they didn't give it up. There was a lot of bad feelings between ranchers and animosity between ranchers. I mean, like, well, you know, we had to give up our debris, you've got debris, or, you know, why are you allowed to have debris and not us? I mean, it didn't really make sense. It was just people talking. The bottom line was, is exactly what Sandy said. The military came in, and if they heard any rumors at all of someone having debris, they would track that person down and take it from them. Now, there was a rumor that was a rancher. A couple years later, he's in the general area. And even though the debris site is a skip site where something came down and skipped, wind blew that night, there was a storm. So, you know, if he had really light material, it could have blown for a long time. Could have got caught up in, you know, dust devils and taken a mile down the road.
Sandy Proctor still lives on their ranch, where his late brother Dee allegedly found remnants of the Roswell crash of 1947.
Mr. Proctor.
Sandy Proctor.
Can I call you Sandy?
Yes.
Chuck Zukowski.
Hi, Sandy. I'm Heather. Nice to meet you.
I've been investigating the 47 incident for years. I always wanted to talk to someone from the Proctor family to get your side. What Dee saw, what did he say, or what do you remember?
Mac Brazel had my little brother down there. And they came up on this wreckage, and he showed Mama where the wreckage was.
So your mom actually saw some of the wreckage then?
She seen a piece of stuff, but it would not take heat. We could not cut it. It looked like aluminum foil, but it was stouter than aluminum foil, but it would crumble like aluminum foil and then go back to shape.
You're talking about memory metal.
Yes. So you believe your mom actually saw and touched memory metal?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I do.
Memory metal has been theorized as either an experimental military material or recovered alien technology.
When the military came in, they combed this area for miles going one direction, miles going the other, picking up any piece of this stuff they could find out. Our good old American government, mm-hmm. Mac, he needed to keep his mouth shut. He never would talk about it again.
Do you yourself think that there's still debris hidden around somewhere?
Yeah, I do on that deal. I wouldn't know how to find it.
What about the Proctor family? I heard that the Proctor family had debris for a while.
Well, that's a bunch of crap. I don't care what y'all say. I mean, it is. No.
We never had
no debris.
Okay.
Sandy brings Chuck and Heather to the outskirts of his land, where the mysterious debris was discovered over 70 years ago.
My brother and them was with Mac. They found it right down in there.
This is it.
This is it?
This is the site, 1947, where Mac Brazel found the debris.
You know, the military, they went probably 10 miles every direction around here looking for stuff.
Something came down here
and
hit hard.
Something came down right here.
Standing over the original debris site, Chuck reveals his key piece of evidence.
There's a crude map I'd want you to take a look at for us.
Okay.
And see if you recognize any landmarks or anything on the map. I got a hold of this. Anything on this map ring a bell.
Who did you get this information from? Okay, now take this off the cameras.
Backed into a corner, Chuck has no choice but to tell Sandy about his government informant.
Yeah. All right.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
In
this territory, when you tell people you're connected with the government
whistleblower,
they'll open up to you.
A lot of people around here don't trust the government.
They give me information because they know I want to discover the truth, no matter how much the government wants to shut it down.
All right.
Yeah. Say if it's a Corona crash site, if they're looking at it this way, it looks like it's in the mountain area or...
All right. So that's the Guyana Peak.
Where is Guyana's Peak?
Well, when we get over there on that high point where I can show you Guyana's Peak, I'll show you Guyana's Peak.
The fact that Sandy could look at this map and decipher those symbols as the Guyana's Peak, this tells me that we're on a trail for the mother lode of all UFO discoveries.
So that's the Guyana's Peak right over through there.
How far do you think that is from here?
25 to 30 miles of the Crope lies.
That's where we're headed.